Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Wizard of Uppsala. Chapter 1. The Mysterious Encounter. In the ancient city of Uppsala, known for its storied past and prestigious university, a young student named Erik Johansson found his life taking an unexpected turn. Erik, a history major with a keen interest in Norse mythology, was wandering through the city's historic district when he stumbled upon a peculiar antique shop tucked away in a forgotten alley. The shop, Runes and Mysteries, was filled with artifacts and tomes that spoke of a time when magic was believed to be as real as the land and sky. It was here that Erik first encountered Nils, an enigmatic figure who claimed to be a practitioner of the ancient art of Nordic magic. Nils, with his deep knowledge of runes, sagas, and the esoteric traditions of the Nordic people, saw in Erik a rare spark of curiosity and an open mind. He offered to take Erik under his wing and introduce him to the world of Nordic magic, a world where the legends and myths of old were more than just stories. Intrigued by this mysterious offer and driven by a desire to delve deeper into his heritage, Erik agreed. Thus began his journey into the arcane, a path that would forever change his understanding of reality. Nils started Erik's education with the basics of Nordic magic, the meanings of runes, the importance of nature and Norse beliefs, and the lore surrounding the Norse gods. Erik learned to read and cast runes, to understand their power in divination and their use in ancient spells. As his training progressed, Erik's skepticism waned, replaced by a sense of wonder and a growing belief in the mystical. He learned about the world tree, Yggdrasil, the nine realms of Norse cosmology, and the magical creatures and beings that inhabited them. Nils also taught him about the sagas, the epic stories that were not only tales of heroes and gods but also encoded wisdom of magical practices. Their lessons often took place in the forests surrounding Uppsala, where Nils showed Erik how to connect with the natural world and draw upon its energy. They visited ancient sites, stone circles, and burial mounds, where Nils demonstrated rituals and spells that had been passed down through generations. However, as Erik delved deeper into his studies, he began to notice that they were not alone in their pursuit of ancient knowledge. They were being watched. Shadowy figures observed their activities, and strange occurrences began to happen around Erik, mysterious symbols appearing near his home, cryptic messages in his university locker, and the feeling of being followed. One evening, while practicing rune casting in the forest, Erik and Nils were confronted by a group of individuals cloaked in dark robes. The leader, a man with an air of authority and menace, demanded that Nils hand over a particular ancient tome that was said to contain powerful spells and secrets of forgotten magic. Nils refused, and a tense standoff ensued. It was then that Erik realized the gravity of the world he had stepped into. This was not just a study of old myths and folklore. They were embroiled in a dangerous game that involved powerful forces who sought to control the ancient magic for their own ends. The confrontation was interrupted by a sudden and mysterious fog that enveloped the area. Nils seized the opportunity to usher Erik away from the danger, using a spell to conceal their escape. As they retreated, Eric's heart raced with a mixture of fear and exhilaration. He now knew that his journey into the world of Nordic magic was not just an academic pursuit, but a venture into a hidden world of power, mystery, and danger. Determined to uncover the truth behind the tome and the identity of their pursuers, Erik and Nils embarked on a journey that would take them across Sweden. They traveled to ancient libraries, consulted with scholars of Norse history, and sought out other practitioners of the old ways. Each destination brought new pieces of the puzzle. They learned that the tome in question was known as the Galdrabok, an ancient book of spells that was believed to hold the key to untold power. It was a relic from a time when magic and reality were intertwined, a time that modern history had forgotten. As they pieced together the clues about the Galdrabok's location and the identity of their mysterious adversaries, Erik's knowledge and skills in magic grew. He learned to cast more complex spells to protect himself and Nils from those who sought to do them harm. He also began to understand the responsibility that came with this knowledge, the need to protect these ancient secrets from those who would misuse them. Their quest led them through the mystical landscapes of Sweden, from the runic stones of Gamla Uppsala to the windswept shores of Gotland. Each location brought them closer to the Galdrabok, and each step forward drew them deeper into a web of intrigue and ancient rivalries. Throughout his journey, Erik was forced to confront his doubts and fears, to challenge his understanding of the world, and to embrace a part of his heritage that he had never known existed. He had started as a curious student, seeking to understand the myths of his ancestors. Now, he found himself at the center of a struggle for a power that bridged the past and the present, a power that could shape the future. Chapter 2. A Trail of Legends. Erik Johansson's apprenticeship with the wizard Nils rapidly evolved into a perilous adventure as they uncovered clues about a long-lost magical artifact, a runestone of immense power. This artifact, according to ancient lore, was capable of altering reality itself and had been lost during the tumultuous times of Nordic wars and conquests. The first clue to the runestone's whereabouts came from an ancient map they discovered in the Uppsala University Library's rare collection. The map, drawn on parchment that was brittle with age, depicted an area in the Swedish wilderness not far from the town of Sigtuna, once a flourishing Viking Age settlement. Nils explained that the runestone was part of a set that was used in ancient rituals to communicate with the gods and harness the elements. The stone they sought was said to be imbued with the essence of Ymir, the primeval being from Norse cosmology, and held control over the very fabric of the natural world. Their journey took them through dense forests and along rugged coastlines, where they encountered remnants of ancient Nordic civilization, runestones standing silent in the wilderness, old burial mounds overgrown with moss, and ruins of long-forgotten settlements. As they followed the map's directions, Erik's skills in magic and his understanding of the ancient Nordic world grew. Nils taught him how to decipher runic inscriptions, to sense the presence of magic, and to tap into the energy that flowed through the ancient land. But their quest was fraught with danger. They were not the only ones seeking the runestone. A rival sorcerer, known only as Asmund, was also on the trail of the artifact. Asmund believed that the runestone would grant him powers to dominate and control, and he was willing to go to any lengths to acquire it. Erik and Nils first encountered Asmund's minions in a shadowy forest near an ancient Viking burial site. The confrontation was sudden and fierce, with Erik narrowly escaping a curse hurled by one of the minions. It was a stark reminder that their journey was a race against time and dark forces. The trail led them next to the shores of Lake Malarin, where local legends spoke of a mysterious island that appeared only at the break of dawn on the summer solstice. It was on this island, the legends claimed, that the runestone was hidden. As the solstice approached, Erik and Nils prepared for the most dangerous part of their journey. They camped near the lake, waiting for the first light of dawn to reveal the mystical island. In the quiet of the night, Nils shared stories of the ancient gods, of Odin's wisdom, Thor's might, and Freya's magic, stories that wove the tapestry of the world they were delving into. With the first light of dawn, the island emerged from the mist, a rocky outcrop covered in dense vegetation, with an ancient standing stone at its center. Erik and Nils made their way to the island, aware that Asmund would not be far behind. The island was a place out of time, its air thick with magic. The standing stone, covered in runic inscriptions, was the key to uncovering the runestone. Erik, using the knowledge he had gained, worked with Nils to unlock the standing stone's secrets. But as they worked, Asmund and his followers arrived, setting the stage for a confrontation. A battle of magic ensued, with spells clashing against spells, the air crackling with energy. Erik found himself not just a student but an active participant, using his newfound abilities to counter Asmund's attacks. The clash reached its peak as the sun rose higher in the sky, the magic of the solstice amplifying the power at play. In the midst of the chaos, Erik and Nils managed to unlock the standing stone, revealing a hidden chamber beneath the island. Inside the chamber lay the runestone, its surface glowing with an ethereal light. As Erik reached out to touch it, he felt a surge of power, a connection to the ancient world of the Norse gods and their elemental forces. With the runestone in their possession, Erik and Nils had to make a quick escape as the island began to vanish with the rising sun. They raced against time, dodging Asmund's relentless pursuit as the island disappeared beneath the waters of Lake Malarin. Back on the mainland, with the runestone secured, Erik and Nils knew that their journey was far from over. The artifact's power had to be safeguarded, and Asmund's threat remained. They needed to decipher the stone's inscriptions and understand its true capabilities before it could fall into the wrong hands. Their adventure had taken them through the heart of Sweden's ancient past, uncovering secrets long buried and powers long forgotten. Erik, once a mere student of history, had become a custodian of a magical legacy that intertwined with the very fabric of the Nordic world. As they prepared for the next phase of their journey, Erik and Nils knew that they were part of a story much larger than themselves, a story that spanned the annals of time and the depths of magic. The runestone was a key to unlocking mysteries of the past and shaping the future, and they were its guardians. Chapter 3. The Chase Through Time. Erik Johansson and Nils, with the rune stone in their possession, found themselves in a perilous game of cat and mouse with Asmund, the rival sorcerer. Asmund, driven by a desire for power, sought the runestone to bend the fabric of reality to his will. The confrontation between them transcended the physical realm as they harnessed ancient magic to travel through time and space. Their first encounter with Asmund after acquiring the runestone was in the streets of modern-day Uppsala. Asmund, wielding dark magic, attempted to wrest the stone from their grasp. In the ensuing struggle, Nils used the runestone to open a portal, a gateway that whisked them away from the present and into the past. They emerged in Viking-era Sweden, a time of warriors and legends. The landscape was rugged and untamed, a stark contrast to the Uppsala they had just left. In this era, the power of the runestone was even more potent, its connection to the land and its history more pronounced. Erik and Nils found themselves pursued not only by Asmund but also by Viking warriors who were drawn to the stone's power. They navigated through ancient forests, across fjords, and into mead halls, where tales of gods and giants were spun by skalds. In one harrowing encounter, they were captured by a band of Vikings who believed the runestone to be a gift from the gods. It took all of Erik's newfound magical abilities and Nils' wisdom to escape, using illusions and cunning to slip away into the night. As they journeyed through the Viking Age, Erik and Nils sought refuge in an old temple dedicated to Odin. There, Nils explained that the runestone's power was anchored in the land's history. Each era they traveled to held different challenges and opportunities for using the stone's magic. Their respite was short-lived, however, as Asmund, using his sorcery, tracked them down. A battle ensued within the temple, a clash of magical forces that shook the very foundations of the structure. In the midst of the chaos, Nils once again used the runestone to open a portal, this time transporting them to medieval Sweden. They arrived in a time of castles and knights, a period rife with intrigue and conflict. The medieval landscape presented new dangers, as local lords and clergy sought to claim the runestone for their own purposes, believing it to be a holy relic. Erik and Nils navigated through this complex political landscape, encountering knights on horseback and monks in secluded monasteries. They learned of a secret society, the Keepers of the Runes, who had once guarded the runestone and others like it. This society, now long forgotten, had understood the true nature of the stones and their connection to the world. As they sought more information about the Keepers, Asmund once again caught up to them. In a fortified castle, amidst a raging storm, they confronted Asmund. The storm outside mirrored the magical battle within, as lightning and thunderbolts were conjured and hurled with spell and incantation. During the confrontation, Erik discovered a hidden strength within himself. He tapped into the runestone's power, channeling its energy in ways he had never imagined. The battle ended with Asmund retreating, but not before vowing to return and claim the runestone. Realizing that they could not keep running forever, Erik and Nils decided to take the fight to Asmund. They used the runestone to travel to a time and place where they believed they could finally end Asmund's pursuit. Their journey through time brought them to early modern Sweden, a time when old beliefs were fading and new ideas were taking root. Here, they prepared for the final confrontation with Asmund, gathering allies and resources. They learned that Asmund had entrenched himself in an ancient fortress, using its ancient energies to bolster his power. Erik and Nils, along with a band of allies they had gathered across time, Vikings, knights, and scholars, laid siege to the fortress in a battle that was both physical and magical. The siege was intense and grueling. Erik, now a skilled practitioner of magic, faced off against Asmund's minions, breaking through their defenses with spells he had learned from Nils and the wisdom he had gained from his travels through time. As they breached the fortress, Erik and Nils confronted Asmund in a final, decisive battle. Asmund, driven to madness by his lust for power, unleashed the full extent of his dark magic. But Erik and Nils, strengthened by their journey and the alliances they had formed, countered with the combined might of their own magic and the runestone's power. In the climax of the battle, Erik used the runestone to trap Asmund in a temporal loop, a prison from which he could never escape. With Asmund defeated, the runestone's power was finally contained, ensuring that it would no longer pose a threat to the world. The victory was bittersweet, as Erik and Nils knew that the runestone, for all its power, was too dangerous to be left unchecked. They decided to hide the stone, entrusting it to the keepers of the runes, who had reformed in the wake of Asmund's defeat. Their journey through time had come to an end. Erik and Nils returned to modern-day Uppsala, their mission complete. The experience had changed Erik profoundly. He had started as a curious student and had become a guardian of ancient magic and a defender of history. As they walked through the streets of Uppsala, Erik realized that his adventure had been more than just a pursuit of an artifact. It was a journey through the heart of Sweden's history, a journey that had shown him the power of knowledge and the importance of protecting the past. Erik's life returned to a semblance of normality, but he was forever changed. He continued his studies, now with a deeper understanding and respect for the magical traditions of his ancestors. And though he had left the world of time traveling and magical battles behind, he knew that the experiences he had gained would always be a part of him, a reminder of the adventure that had spanned the ages. Chapter 4. The Final Confrontation. In the dim light of dawn, amidst the ruins of an ancient Viking fortress, Erik Johansson and Nils prepared for their final confrontation with Asmund, the sorcerer who had relentlessly pursued them through time for the powerful runestone. The fortress, perched on a cliff overlooking the sea, was steeped in Norse history and resonated with the echoes of ancient battles. Erik, now proficient in the art of Nordic magic, felt a mix of apprehension and determination. He had come far from the skeptical student who first met Nils in Uppsala. Now, he stood ready to defend the runestone and prevent it from falling into the hands of someone who would use its power for destruction. As the first rays of sunlight pierced the horizon, Asmund appeared, his presence heralding a palpable shift in the air. The final battle commenced with a fury of magical energy. Asmund, fueled by his desire for power, unleashed a barrage of dark spells. The fortress became a battleground of fire and shadow as spells clashed against ancient stone. Nils, wise and experienced, countered Asmund's attacks, while guiding Erik in using the runestone's power. The stone, glowing with an inner light, was a nexus of ancient energy. Erik, drawing upon his learnings and the adventures they had experienced, channeled the stone's power, creating shields and countering Asmund's offensive. The bow raged, with Erik and Nils slowly gaining the upper hand. However, Asmund, desperate and realizing he was being bested, attempted a forbidden spell, one that would rip apart the fabric of reality itself. The air crackled with dangerous energy, threatening to engulf them all in a maelstrom of uncontrolled magic. Erik, understanding the gravity of the situation, made a split-second decision. Utilizing a combination of runes and the innate power of the runestone, he created a vortex that absorbed Asmund's spell, redirecting the energy back towards the sorcerer. The backlash of the spell trapped Asmund in a temporal loop, effectively removing him from their timeline and ending his threat. With Asmund defeated, the runestone's power surged, threatening to spiral out of control. Erik and Nils worked together to stabilize the stone, using ancient incantations to calm its energy. The stone's light dimmed, its power contained but still potent. The battle won, Erik and Nils were left to ponder the implications of their victory. The runestone, while a powerful artifact, was too dangerous to be left unchecked. They decided that it must be hidden away, protected from those who might seek to misuse its power. They journeyed to a secluded location in the Swedish wilderness, a place where the veil between the natural and the magical was thin. There, they performed a ritual to conceal the runestone, entrusting its safeguarding to the earth itself. The location was marked only by a simple rune, known only to them and the spirits of the land. In the aftermath of their adventure, Erik returned to Uppsala, his life forever changed by the journey he had undertaken. He resumed his studies, but with a newfound perspective on the history and mythology he had once viewed only through the lens of academia. His experiences had given him a deeper appreciation for the mystical and the magical elements of history often left in the shadows. Nils, his mentor and friend, continued his role as a guardian of ancient knowledge, ever watchful for signs of magical disturbances or those who might seek the runestone for their purposes. Erik often reflected on their journey, the lessons he had learned, and the battles they had fought. He realized that their adventure had been more than just a quest to find and protect a magical artifact. It was a journey through the rich tapestry of Nordic history, a voyage across time that had revealed the enduring power of legend and myth. The runestone, now hidden from the world, remained a symbol of that journey, a testament to the fact that magic, in its many forms, was woven into the fabric of the world. It was a part of the past, present, and future, a legacy of a time when the boundaries between the earthly and the divine were blurred. Erik's adventures with Nils had also taught him about responsibility, the responsibility to protect and preserve the ancient wisdom and to use one's knowledge for the greater good. He had seen firsthand the dangers of power unchecked and the importance of maintaining a balance between the magical and the mundane. As Erik walked the streets of Uppsala, past the university and the ancient sites steeped in history, he felt a connection to the past that was more profound than ever before. He knew that the world was more complex and wondrous than most could imagine, and that magic, in many ways, was very much real and present. His journey with Nils had ended, but Erik knew that his own journey was just beginning. He had opened a door to a world of magic and mystery, and there was no going back. The lessons he had learned and the powers he had tapped into were now a part of him, guiding him as he continued to explore the depths of history and the mysteries of the magical world. In the years to come, Erik would become a bridge between the academic world and the realm of the mystical. He would share his experiences and knowledge with those who sought to understand the deeper truths of the world, always mindful of the balance between revealing and protecting the ancient secrets. The rune stone, hidden away in the heart of Sweden, remained a silent guardian of these truths, a reminder of the adventure that had spanned time and space, and a symbol of the enduring magic that underlies our world.